Couldn't find it last time either. That's too bad. I really like that anti-seize. Actually, I hope these pads come with some. If they don't, I'll really have to find the anti-seize. No. No anti-seize in here. Keep them from squeaking when they're on there. Crap.
Yes, I found it.
One, you only have to buy one of these, it'll last you your whole life. Doesn't take much. And the next time you go to take it off, go to take a bolt off, it'll be so much easier. It's really nice, especially like wheels and stuff. You never have to struggle. All right. Got these little Audi non-removable washers. Right. Be careful not to touch the rotor with your greasy fingers. Apparently that's very bad. Brakes will never work again if you do. Come on. Where is the hole? Shmoo. Release the shmoo. Probably shouldn't be wearing this nice leather jacket, but it was free and, you know, so whatever. It's kind of beat up anyway. Really? I feel like I'm doing something wrong here. Indeed I am. Aren't I? Come on. Come on. Slow down. Someday I'll get these bolts in. And we'll be sitting pretty. Wow, I think I might have them like reversed. Ah. struggle is real. This is ridiculous. Do these even go in here? Yeah, look at that. They do.
Amazing. What the fuck? What the fuck?
Life is hard.
Turned the wheel, but I was too lazy to get up. Just here, I'll do that on the other side. Look at all that shmoo I got on there. Yeah, I guess it was just the salty roads that did that rotor in. Unfortunately, that's the reality with salt, is that things wear out long before they would have otherwise, and it just causes so much damage to cars. It's unbelievable. Not only cars, but people track it inside with them everywhere they go on their shoes. It ruins their shoes, ruins the floors. I don't hate salt anything. I do. I hate salted roads. In Colorado and Canada, they use beet juice as an anti-ice agent on the road. It seems to work fine for them. So, attention to which side the sensor was on, huh? If I had to guess, I'd say the back. I'll go look on the other side. Side has the clip on it here. So. Yeah, that's right. Sensor goes on the inside. Okay. Now. Sensor clipped in here. Oh, there's some schmoo in there, preventing it from closing. Everything's covered in crud, mud, salt, and water. Make sure that's on good. Okay, so this, there's a pain in the butt. All right, I'm just gonna have to, normally I don't reuse it. I'm gonna take this out of here. I'm trying to put my fingers on it too much. Into here. Oh.
There we go. Like a glove. I can see why AVE is not fond of the Spring-a-ma-things. Spring-a-ma-thing. So close. Okay. Okay. My Uncle Eric. It's a pretty funny story. Oh, there we go. He wanted to hang something on a brick wall, a metal frame. He didn't have any wire to hang it with. So he decided to find some wire like off of something and cut it off and make it into a hanging wire. And he ended up deciding to use a spring. Like a little spring. You wanted to bend it up into a shape that would hold something on a wall. And, you know, after he spent a good 10 or 20 minutes doing that, I realized, oh, springs are made of spring steel, specifically made to resist permanent changes in shape. They're made to resist bending. They're purposefully made to spring back their original shape. Like, millions of dollars in research, special like factories and quenching processes and tempering and everything to make this amazing, strong steel that can bend so much but always comes back to shape. And he's trying his damnedest to make it not come back to shape. Bending it, and keeps bringing me back. Like, Eric, you know, that's spring steel. That's made not to bend. I'm like, you have a lot easier time finding something else, but oh no. He persevered. And he spent at least an hour. I think he probably spent a good 2 hours finally bending that spring into a longer shape that could hold up a picture frame. That was pretty funny just because of what a specialty kind of steel that is. How much research and man hours have gone into making like spring steel be able to do what it does. And he's fighting all of that with every ounce of stubbornness he has to bend it to the shape he wants. Oh my god. Alright, so I guess we should put on the winter tires. I really want to take off all four of my wheels. I'm just gonna put the all season back on. But first, I should probably put the last few bolts in. I should be lubing these. these up or not, but I'm going to anyway. Power of the shmoo compels me. Because they're slide pins, so they're supposed to be slidey. So I think that's going to help. There. That's better. Oh, it's going in. Man, those pads didn't come with lube, and they didn't come with anti-squeal thing, lube they normally do, and they didn't come with new spring in the things here. So, all the pads I've ever bought before have. I guess I didn't get them a bomb this time because AutoZone had, Advance Auto had cheaper, a little bit cheaper brakes. $10 less. Victory shredder. I should go a lot quicker now that I know how it works here. Been a while since I've done brakes. Nice and snug. Alright. Don't forget our little caps. I've already lost one somewhere. Final work on our bin bolts here. Should be tight enough. I think that's the recommended torque spec. This is about that tight. Yeah, that's the spec right there. Perfect. All right. How are we doing? 21 minutes. Oh, not too bad. I thought it was getting really long here because I was kind of figuring out how to do stuff and looking for tools and stuff, but 21 minutes isn't too bad. For a video on the YouTubes. See, all this mud and stuff can give you a wheel wobble. And I was getting a little wobbling, so hopefully this is what it was, not the, hopefully I don't have to pay to actually get my wheels bounced again. I really like these aluminum 15s, they're so light. I saw some 5 spokes on another A4. I didn't know they came with 5 spokes. I'd love to change to get some. Now, where are my lug nuts? Aha! So tired. All right. Now, dab of the shmoo. I cannot lift wheels one-handed like this normally. Some pretty light bastards here. Alright. Alright. Oh yeah. That was like the easiest wheel I've ever put on. Brake should work a little bit better now. At least this side will. Oh, that wasn't too bad. Spec on these is approximately 3 good stomps. Not too hard. Really easy to over torque these. And be gentle. And be gentle. It's not gonna come off. I've had them come loose before, like they it's really, really gradual. Like there's very slight vibration and you'll hear a tiny bit of noise and go miles and miles, and it'll get slowly more vibration, more noise, and you're like, oh, maybe my lug nuts are loose. All right. Bingo bango. That side's done. Stop this one here, and we're going to...